What's going on, guys? It's your boy Scrub here, back again with another video. Hope you guys are having a great day. I know I am, and if you are, be sure to press the like, but otherwise, no joke, no scam. You're going to be smacked in the face by a beach ball that flies through your window. I don't care how far away you are from the ocean, I've placed them all strategically outside your houses, so press the like button right now. I honestly did not have the best time in school, okay? I mean, don't get me wrong, I had fun, but I did not get along with teachers very well. However, I did have a couple teachers that were honestly just like complete savages, alright? I will say the one good thing about American high school is the fact that we have like 12 teachers a year, so I just have stories for days because, I don't know, we just were switching teachers every like 45 minutes at my school. Regardless, guys, this person was an absolute savage. Like, honestly, up there was one of the only teachers I've ever had that I think could honestly smack me in my place. And, yeah, they've just did some pretty entertaining stuff, so I figured I would tell a story about this today. Without further ado, let's get into it. So, I don't really know how PE works in other places, but at least, like, where I lived, okay, we basically just had, like, 4 PE coaches that would be together, and, like, 300 kids would just be grouped up in the middle of the field and told to just, you know, sports until we got an A. And most of our PE coaches were honestly pretty chill. Like, 99% of them were basically just there to have a job at the school so they could coach a sport, and they really did not care at all. I had a couple PE coaches that were just, like, blind to the fact that, you know, kids were just getting bullied and stuff, but this is not one of those stories. Nevada is super weird. We're a really fat state, okay? So I guess in order to fix the fatness in our state, they just decided that we had to take a lot of PE in high school. And I mean, it didn't really help a bunch. There were still a lot of fat kids because school PE is a little bit of a joke, but at least they were trying, you know? So like, I had already taken PE 1 year, all right? I had already done it once, but you have to do it twice in order to graduate in my state. It's super weird. I don't know why. So I sign up for PE again, and when I get my class schedule, I don't recognize any of the coaches. It's a name that I don't recognize. And usually whenever we got like a new teacher at our school, there would be some rumor about them, you know, oh my god, I heard at their old school they like beat a kid with an eraser until his head literally became shaped like a dry erase marker, you know, like there's just some dumb rumor. But I hadn't heard anything about this dude yet. So I walk in on the first day of school to like, you know, the weird, welcome to the first day, this is PE, so we're gonna be doing physical activity, like where the teachers basically explain the most obvious stuff ever. I've never understood that. What's up, guys? Welcome to history. We're gonna be learning about old stuff. Wow, you don't say. I never would have thought. I thought this history class was gonna teach me how to make meth in the back of an RV in the New Mexico desert. Anyways, we're standing there, like, all gathered around, listening to this coach talk about how, you know, PE is important, and that's what we're gonna be learning. All this stuff that I'm pretty sure he, like, legally has to say as a PE teacher. And there was a kid next to me that was, like, talking, you know? And immediately when we walked in, I guess I should describe what this dude looked like. This dude looked like Stan from American Dad, all right? Like, he was just the most just like, hello, I'm American and I teach PE and I like steak. Like, he just looked like the most American dude ever. So whatever, he's teaching us about PE, and there's a kid next to me that's talking about, like, you know, what he did this summer with his friends. And all I see is Stan from American Dad pick up an eraser and hurl that hoe with the speed of a Major League Baseball fastball as fast as he can and smack the kid next to me talking in the side of the head. And he goes, unless you got something to share with the class, I suggest you keep your mouth shut while I'm talking. And it's at this moment that I realize that this man might not actually be a PE teacher, okay? He might be an FBI agent sent here to single-handedly scout the school for good spies, because this dude seriously just hit a Chris Kyle sniper shot with a dry eraser on some kid talking like 6 feet up in the bleachers, all right? That's a hard shot. But at that moment, I kind of realized that this dude is gonna be a savage, and a savage he was. I'm just gonna break down some highlights, alright, because there's way too many to talk about, like, everything in specifics. I would be here for an hour. One day, alright, this guy was complaining about the fact that, like, something that the coach had given him was loosely fitting. Like, I think it was, like, the goalie glove or something, and that's why he wasn't able to stop anything during hockey. And our coach looked at him and said, well, you would know a thing or two about things that feel loose considering you came out of your mother. Like, without missing a beat, dude, he said that to a child as a PE coach. Like, This dude was just a savage. He did not care at all. I remember one time some kids asked him what he would do if there was a fight in his PE class, and he said, honestly, I'd probably pull out my phone and start filming it. That way I could send it to everybody on Facebook. Like, this teacher honestly did not care at all. But the level of not caring not only existed when, like, students were around, all right? Like, you know, he would call your mom loose. He would basically tell you that he wanted you guys to fight. But on top of that, I'm not even kidding. There was a couple times where he would, like, be like, yeah, you guys should fight to settle this. You're not going to settle this with your words. Like, the most non-teacher thing of all time. You know how every English teacher you ever had is like, guys, remember, violence is never the answer. Use your words, not your fists. And I remember one time these kids weren't getting along because of something out of PE, and like they were arguing and pushing each other in the locker room, and he walks in and goes, stop pushing each other and throw some punches. I'm not coming out of my room for 5 minutes. You have until then. And then walked back inside. Like, he really just did not care at all. And the weirdest thing is, most PE coaches at our school like coached a sports team or something. This dude didn't. He would just show up, teach PE, tell kids to fight in the locker room, and leave. Like, it was just the weirdest thing ever. I'm pretty sure he would show up to his job just absolutely smashed too, because, like, sometimes, some days, he would have sunglasses on and be, like, slurring his words and stuff. This teacher did not care. I think encouraging kids to fight, though, is honestly one of the funniest things a teacher could do. Like, oh, you guys got beef? Well, you know, start fighting. I got 20 bucks on Timmy, okay? He's definitely my favorite. He's got a better mile speed, and we all know he's better at football than you, so that's my bet. Like, running a gambling ring for a fight club in PE would have made way more sense if you don't care about the rules anyways. That's what we should have done. But I can honestly tell you that his most savage moment came during his end of year evaluation. So teachers have like evaluations, I'm pretty sure everybody knows that, where like the principal or the dean or somebody in charge of the school comes and like watches them teach for a class just to make sure that they're doing it right. And I don't really know how to tell if someone's being like a good PE teacher. As long as the kids are running, then like I guess they're doing a good job. I don't really know how you can fail, but whatever. The day that the principal comes to watch our PE teacher teach a class and he's supposed to be all impressive, he decides that, you know, we're gonna do the good old-fashioned game of playing dodgeball. Except this is how savage he is. So, like, at the time, our school had just gotten these little foam balls to throw instead. You guys know the foam balls that you use in dodgeball, and they, like, really don't hurt too much. I mean, if you really get them going, I guess they can sting, but like, it's not enough. And our principal is watching, and I'm not even kidding you. He goes, we're not gonna play dodgeball with these balls because, you know, they don't hurt enough. And that's the lesson of dodgeball. So I brought these from home, and out of nowhere, like, goes to his office, pulls out a duffel bag full of those ginormous red rubber balls, right? Like, the ginormous red rubber balls that hurt and weigh a lot, and like, if you got smacked in the face with one of those, it would leave that waffle cone print all over the side of your head. Like, it would just not be a good time. I'm really not trying to have my face look like an abstract art project, so I'm kind of, like, terrified of this. And the principal, you know, is, well, I don't know, you know, it is a liability thing. We don't want them to get hurt. And he looks at the principal and goes, oh, no, they won't get hurt.
Trust me, people are about to get hurt.
So whatever, we pick teams, and sure enough, as it always happens in PE, there's one team of, like, all the athletic kids, and then one team of everybody else. So I'm on the team with everybody else, just straight up vibing. I did not look like an athlete when I was in high school. I guess I still don't. I don't know why I'm acting like I look like I'm supposed to be an Olympian, dude. I looked like a string bean noodle. So whatever. The athletic kids are on one side and all the nerdy kids are on the other. And the game's about to start. All the balls are lined up. The nerds realize we're about to get decimated by getting smacked with things that actually hurt. And the PE coach goes onto the athletic kid team and says, well, I figured I should play just so that way I can show you guys how it's done. This grown man is about to start pelting me with rubber balls that were made that he brought from home to cause more pain. So the game starts and all of us nerds are immediately getting decimated. And I've told another story about dodgeball on here where we had one guy who like dodged everything and clutched it. Yeah, nah, we did not have this time. So I get smacked relatively early. It doesn't hurt that bad. I get like hit in the shoulder, whatever. I go out. So it gets to the end of the game and it's like the coach and three very athletic people versus like two very nerdy people on our team. All right. They won very handily. But instead of just like, you know, hitting the kids with the two balls and like, you know, calling it a day in front of the principal, showing them how good of a coach he is, I don't know why our coach decides to do this. He pulls back and let's go, a Tom Brady missile, dude. He is trying to compete and complete a Hail Mary in the Super Bowl. He lets it fly, and it smacks into this kid playing dodgeball with glasses, and it's like just crunch. All you hear is a crunch. That's obviously a little bit more than the glasses. His nose starts pouring blood, his glasses fall off of his face, and the gym just goes absolutely silent. So obviously it's just silent because we just witnessed our teacher just absolutely shatter a kid's nose with a dodgeball. So the principal gets up and like goes to the kid and is like, go to the nurse's office. And our PE coach is like, I'm so sorry, I didn't mean to break your nose. The only time I've ever seen him apologize. But after his apology, which was like very half-butted, oh, I almost said a naughty word, he goes, well, whatever, I guess noses re-heal, right? As if he wasn't just a grown man who brought balls from home to specifically hurt children more and just broke a kid's nose. Like, he was acting like it was no big deal. But here's what's even weirder. Our principal, who was like evaluating him, didn't care. He didn't get in trouble for it at all. Like, nothing happened. The kid's parents thankfully didn't sue the school. That would have been the first thing on my mind, man. A teacher just broke my nose. I'm about to get a settlement, baby. But I guess that's just how my mind thinks. Regardless, guys, that's gonna do it for the video. That's the most savage teacher I've ever had. Breaking kids' noses is pretty savage. He didn't really get in trouble for it, and he continued to just be crazy. I have a couple more stories about this guy, so if this video gets, I don't know, 20,000 likes, I'll do more. So, yeah, be sure to press the like button, and today's notification shout-out goes to Kennedy Boyce. Big thank you for having on notifications. If you want a notification shout out, turn it on when you subscribe if you're new, and send it to my Instagram at Scrubby or Twitter at Scrubby_69, and I shout somebody out every single day. On that note, guys, don't get anyone pregnant. If you do, make sure they're hot. Consider checking out some of the OG Sub Club merch. The tie-dye stuff may be gone because it is June, but its memory will live on forever. Honestly, I think Teespring is going to take a couple days to take it down anyways, so if you haven't gotten it, you still can. But yeah, on that note, guys, I appreciate the shit out of you guys watching every video. Thank you for everything you guys do for me, and I'll see you guys next time with another video. I'm out. Peace.